Monica, hey, pudding, Monica. Hey, hey, Monica, hey, hey, pudding, Monica.
All right, Sam. Take care of her. And don't worry, she won't go necro. Millingen's special. It'd be funny if these Havars ended up being the key to saving us all.
My truck. Okay, just built the road by quite the length. The next one is there. The motherfucker actually built it up there. Okay. So, oh no, these are pre-built stairs, okay. So the next one is there. I want to put out as much resources as I can. Let's see, Bruce. Red. The only way to get there is from here. turns okay once it's going, but it won't turn when it starts to go. So fucking dumb.
To join. Awaiting Cupid.
It's shaped like a heart. Where the fuck is everything padded?
Well, you certainly caught me with my pants down. Glad you could make it, Sam. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to alarm you, but I am what I am. Ah, please, lay her down there. Still no sign of them.
Stops beating.
It stops every 21 minutes. I spend 3 minutes on the beach and then return. 60 deaths and 60 resurrections per day. 60 opportunities to search the beach for my departed family. This is how I live. This is my life. So, while you've traveled to and from the seam an impressive number of times, my beach count is a little higher. 218,549. I see myself in that crater. My wife and my child. It's like looking at the shape of my heart. The doctors called it myocardial cordophobia. Mine is an especially unusual case. I have pictures. Care to see Hartwent's heart-shaped heart? No, you really should. It doesn't run in the family. You know, I never came to terms with their loss. In the days that followed, I became obsessed with an idea. That the beach is real, and they are on it. I would induce cardiac arrest, 3 minutes at a time, and search for them, day after day after day.
Oh, so you could say goodbye?
Quite the opposite. It is said that everyone's beach is different. So what if everyone's afterlife is different too? I find the thought terrifying, spending eternity alone, which is why I decided to find my family and make sure to move on with them.
You mean die with them?
If death would see us reunited, then yes. But the repeated cardiac arrests took their toll on my heart. The muscle gradually deformed. And after a while, they started calling me the beach scientist. Hartman. I'm glad we could have this conversation. Oh. A body that doesn't necrotize. No sign of decomposition. It's as if she were still alive. The perfect mummy. An impeccable corpse.
What's wrong?
Where's the other thing you were supposed to bring? Ah, found it. Behold.
Wait, dead man.
It appears to be an umbilical cord. Human by the looks of it, I think. But this was no ordinary conduit between fetus and placenta. It looks more like a BT's tether. And this was Mama's? Yes. A body that doesn't necrotize and an umbilical cord connected to the beach. These are remarkable discoveries, Sam. Enough to set my sore heart racing.
5 minutes to cardiac arrest.
I apologize if our conversation gets cut short. I must go back to the beach and look for my wife and child. One person, one beach. That's the rule. But I'm the exception. My beach is connected to others, as if it were the beneficiary of a coronary bypass. Maybe this twisted heart of mine made it possible. All I know is that I will find them. Even if my every visit raises new questions, I'll have my answers one day. One day.
3 minutes to cardiac arrest.
The battlefields. The endless wars you found yourself trapped in. Why do World War era soldiers wander the beach a century after they fell? Normally the souls of the dead move on. The beach is just a corridor, a place through which they pass on the way to the other side. But if regret, resentment, a fervent desire to remain If these feelings are powerful enough, they may give rise to an altogether different beach. A collective purgatory for an army of the damned. Clifford Unger. His misery and hatred, combined with your BB acting as some sort of catalyst, have brought these battlefields to our world.
2 minutes to cardiac arrest. Please proceed to a safe location.
It's just a theory.
You think Higgs is pulling his strings? Pulling all their strings?
Ensure you are in a stable position.
I don't know. But evidence does suggest that Higgs brought them here. Oh, before I forget, I have a favor to ask.
Activating lab security measures.
Could you just relax until I come back? Time stops on the beach, but not in the scene. Rest assured, it'll only feel like 3 minutes to you. We'll continue this shortly.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
No luck. Visit 218,550. Oh, sorry. Where were we? I may be used to the 21-minute cycle, but for a first-time face-to-face meeting, there's just too much to cover in one go-around.
Can't be easy living like this.
Yes. And no. Now that I'm acclimated to it, it isn't especially, onerous. Defecation, ablution, nutrition. Most of life's basic functions fit rather easily into a 21-minute time slot. Sleep is the tricky one. And intercourse, I suppose. Verbal or physical. Not that, someone in my position has to worry much about either. Do you read, Sam? Listen to music. Watch films. You know, I keep busy. I have a collection of music, television shows, some very interesting short films, and stories. Everything consumable within a 21-minute window. All from before the Death Stranding, of course. But honestly, the 21 minutes I spend here, all downtime, nothing more. Time spent waiting to go back to the search. My body may be present, but my soul is on the beach. I'm already dead.
I know that feeling. Lost my family in an accident.
Well, I never expected you to open up to me. As it happens, I've read about your circumstances. I lost my family in an accident, too. I was in the ICU having heart surgery, out of town, in the city. When it was clear that I was going to pull through, my wife took my daughter back to the house to collect some things for me. And then they were caught in the void outs. The city and the hospital were spared the worst, but the shockwave knocked out the power and my life support. I woke up on the beach. The people who died in the two void outs were there. What happened? What's going on? I saw my wife and my daughter in the procession. Hey! It's me! Where are you going? Wait! Don't leave without me! No! Don't go! Please! Don't go! The ICU's backup generator kicked in, and I was brought back to life by the defibrillator. Exactly 21 minutes after my heart had stopped. And that was the last time I saw my family. It's my damned heart's fault that we were torn apart, but it's also the reason I'll see them again someday. It defines me. I am Hartman. Ever since, I've walked the beaches of others. I follow my family's footsteps for a while, And when I get tired, I return here to continue my research. It's funny, though. Even when my heart stops, the pain lingers. You have any family photographs, Sam? Pity.
5 minutes to cardiac arrest.
You mind telling me what I'm doing here before you go back to the beach?
Oh, of course. There's a Preparone station in this area. Our scientists stationed there are researching material from before the Death Stranding.
What kind of material?
The Earth has a long memory. It's strata to tell a story, one that goes back to the very beginning, one that not even the Death Stranding could erase. The scientists are all colleagues of mine from the earlier expedition. I'd like you to bring them onto the chiral network. Amelie proposed we establish our research posts along this belt. Despite a worldwide search, this is the only area known to contain fossils from the late Cretaceous period, when the dinosaurs died out. The assumption being that the last ones lived here and here alone. You see, hiding in the Earth then are memories of a major mass extinction. Clues that could tell us how to survive our predicament. Certainly, that was Amelie's hope as part of the advanced team when she assigned our backup team here. The past informs the present and aids us in building the future. She was careful to impress that upon us before she went west.
3 minutes to cardiac arrest.
Shut up. I'm putting you on mute. Sometime later, we began to observe unusual activity in the tar belts outside Edgenot City. Vast quantities of tar began surfacing, spreading, consuming many of my colleagues, as well as a chiral way station. The whole incident defied explanation.
You think Higgs is to blame?
I don't know, but we needed that way station. It was essential to expanding the chiral network westward. That's why I'm asking you for your help in building a new one. It won't be much given the handful of equipment we've managed to scrape together. Nothing like the Knot Cities, that's for sure. But a knot is still a knot. Sam, I want you to use the Cupid to put the scientists on the network, then go to Amelie. Afterwards, we can get back to the important job of researching the deaths.
Oof. Now that's why he has padded floors.
Don't worry about him, Sam. The air mat floor absorbs the impact. I'll unlock the door for you.
Sam, you heard him. You can grab the order at a delivery terminal.
Wait, what the hell? Why is the armor plate off?